Unity Virtual Production Episode 2. What is virtual production? Well, I think the meaning of virtual production is going to be defined over the next couple years. It's super new, right? In simplest terms, virtual production is like a video game. So let's compare video games to VFX. With video games, you have a dynamic world. And in visual effects, you have a static world. You have in video games scripted events, and in visual effects, it's all rendered out. With video games, it's going to be lower resolution, and in visual effects, it's high resolution because you take more time rendering each frame than in a video game where you have to render it in real time. Video games have been low res. Until now. There's becoming a breakthrough point right now where real-time visual effects looks fantastic. Let's dive into what a virtual production would be today in the simplest terms, meaning there's just so much technology and different techniques being used. I'm gonna break this down as simple as possible. So you have an LED wall. The camera is going to feed the information into the computer. The computer is going to combine the information from the virtual production world and the camera's view, and then combine that onto the LED wall. And then here we have a real actor, a virtual actor, a real object, and a virtual object. So what I'm saying is that in this scenario, you have a fake wall, a fake object, and a fake actor, and you have a real camera, a real virtual wall, like a real LED wall with a fake background, and then you have a real actor and one real object. So I'm combining real with not real. Now, another type of virtual production is still using the traditional green screen. However, there's more to working with it on set, because the green screen means that when you bring the footage into post-production, you're able to change the background super easy. You have control over your layers. With a LED wall virtual production, those layers are baked into the shot. Okay, baked in means I can't isolate a layer in post-production to tweak it. And some of these things can be very useful in post-production. Depends on the project and the specific shot, if there was any technical errors. So having the green screen means you do have more control over the image in post. But instead of just staring at a green screen, you can actually show the people on set and the actor what would actually be behind them. Instead of just having to guess, I think the biggest example would be on Lord of the Rings, that people had trouble acting because there was so much green screen, that this thing wouldn't take away all the green screen, but they would have a lot better informed acting. Now, with virtual production, the huge bonus in pre-production is location scouting. Now, when you go to the location, you're going to be able to scan the room or scan the exterior. You're going to place objects and your camera and your lighting on the set. And then all of this, you're going to save to the cloud, and you're going to be able to have somebody else load that information. You're going to be able to directly inform somebody without needing a camera plot or anything that might be too complicated or slow down the process, that you can physically show them. They can have their own device and look around the room and see exactly what you were talking about. There's a lot of things that can go wrong here, but a lot of things that could go right to save time on set, to save time planning, to save time knowing exactly what you want as a creative director. That's my definition of what virtual production is. If you have any comments or anything to add, drop it below. We will discuss in future episodes. We are going to go into so much more in depth on how this works and how we're actually going to implement this into virtual production. So subscribe if you haven't, give me a like, and I'll see you in episode 3.